Hello, and happy leap day! It's February 29th, or it will be, or it was, the day when we celebrate. We don't actually celebrate anything. Leap day is more of an acknowledgement that it takes more than 365 days. 365 days and about 6 hours for us to orbit the sun. And so every 4 years, we need to correct for those 6 hours by adding a full day, because 4 times 6 is 24, I think. It's not exact, but it's close, and if you want to know how we get more exact, you can watch CGP Grey's video on the leap year. I'll put a link to it somewhere nearby me. But that's not actually what this video is about. In addition to those 24 hours, we're also going to be getting a leap second later this year. 2012 is a leap second year. What does that mean? Well, it means that on June 30th at 7:59 and 59 seconds p.m. Eastern Standard Time, a second will be inserted at the U.S. Naval Observatory's Master Atomic Clock Facility in Washington, D.C. Because we have one of those. It's important stuff. It's also being inserted at other timekeeping facilities across the world. This isn't the first time that this has been done. Since 1972, a second has been added to the world's official timekeeping devices 24 times, most recently on December 31st, 2008. But why are we doing it? And why are some people so upset about it? We measure time based on the Earth's rotation relative to the sun. This time is called mean solar time, and it's defined very simply. It takes the amount of time that it takes the Earth to spin and divides that into 24 hours and divides those hours into minutes and seconds, etc. So in a mean day, we have 24 hours. We've defined it that way. There shouldn't be any extra seconds. But turns out that the Earth's rotation is slowing down ever so slightly, which means that the actual spin of the Earth is falling somewhat behind what mean solar time predicts. Yeah, the Earth is slowing down. It's nothing you need to be concerned about. It's basically thanks to the scumbag moon up there, which is literally dragging on us and giving us nothing in return except, like, the tides, which are actually pretty cool and you know, something for werewolves to get all excited about. But it's actually scumbag moon's tidal action that's adding the torque and friction to our rotation, which means that a day in 2012 is 1 to 2 milliseconds longer than it was in 1912. That may not seem like a lot, but it adds up, and since we can't adjust the Earth's rotation yet, we have to adjust our clocks. Earth's official timekeeping is done by atomic clocks, which are not radioactive. People who have told me that you're crazy, they actually just measure the oscillations of an atom. It doesn't have anything to do with radioactivity. And since 1967, a second has been defined as 9,192,631,770 of those oscillations. I'm very excited that I got that.
Oh yeah.
This way of measuring time, called International Atomic Time, is way, 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 way more consistent than mean solar time. The United Kingdom's National Atomic Clock, for instance, is expected to remain accurate within 1 second for the next 138 million years. So that's a bridge we can cross when we come to it, which, you know, we probably won't come to it. So some people argue, and probably rightly, that it's unnecessary to do this extra leap second thing and that it's a big pain in the butt. The extra second has to be added manually to a lot of computer systems that depend on precise timekeeping. And there's a ton of telecommunication and navigation systems that have to be resynced when these changes happen. And it's a nightmare for those people. But the pro leap second people say that eliminating it would create way more problems, especially down the road, like 5,000 years from now, when at this rate the Earth's rotation would be like an hour behind what the atomic clocks say. Even by 2100, the difference would be a couple of minutes or so. The power to break this stalemate ultimately rests with the International Telecommunication Union, a bureau of the UN, which literally defines what time is. And last month, its members voted to postpone a decision on whether to dump the leap second until 2015, saying that more study was needed. And I'm like, holy crap, guys! You have one job! Do it! In the meantime, we have the leap second, and I'm, you know, what are you gonna do with it this year? You get an extra second! So enjoy it. If you have other ideas for things that we should be doing on this show, questions that you would like us to answer, please see us in the YouTube comments below, or of course, on Facebook or Twitter. Goodbye.